This is Saurav. In this video, we will learn how to create music streaming app using MIT App Inventor. So let me show you the demo of this app first, then we will create this app. So you can see that's our app here. And whenever someone opens this app, they can see the previous button, stop button and next button and TCB music streaming. So because we are getting all these music from the server, or you can say the Google Drive. So how we can use it? So we need to click on next button to play this. You can see the zero. Okay, there is no song in zero. But if I click on next, you can see the value is changed is one and the song is started. Stop. If you want to play another song, so you need to click on next again. Stop. Then if you want to play again, 3/4 song. Now if you want to move to the previous songs, you can play the previous song also. Like let me play the first song. We are streaming all these songs from the Google Drive. So we are using here three things. First, MIT App Inventor, Google Drive and Firebase. We have to use all these things. Let me show you how we can create this app. So here we go. So that's our MIT App Inventor. We need to click on start new project and my project name is music streaming. Okay. Now you can see that's our first screen. Now we need to drag and drop here one label, one image, and we need here one layout. Layout is horizontal arrangement, this one, and make this with this fill parent like this. And we need to use here user interface and drag and drop here one button. And make sure change that design of that button. So I'm going to change this design 18 font pixel and text is preview, and then change that background color to something that you love and make it font bold, make it text color going to white, and then I'm going to copy paste this three times and make it in this stop, and third one is I'm to make it next. Now click on horizontal arrangement and make this one in a center, not vertical. We will make it horizontal center like this. Now we need to change the background color of this screen. So I'm to make this background color to black, and we need to change that label text color to white, and we will use your font size at least 20 or 25 and make this one value should be 0 here, and make this one font bold like this, make it 30 or something like that. Yes, and make this screen in the label center and top center like this. We can make align vertical should be top, it's fine. Now we need to use one add image. You can add any image here, it's not compulsory. I'm going to make upload file, so I'm going to upload one image here, this one. Okay, and make this image height is at least in a percentage is around 40 like this, or make this width is fill parent like this, and change that horizontal background color also to black, right? So that's your the overall design. You can use anything here, you can display some label here, anything what you want. And the screen, you can change that screen name to something music app or streaming app. Now that's our app design. Now we have to code. So first we need one extension here, so go to the Coding Buzz website and you will find your extensions, this one, and now just control F and you'll find your drive file display extension, this one. We need to click on download button extension. I will give you the link, direct link of this extension, and you need to download this extension AIX file. This extension name is drive file display extension. Go to App Inventor, click on extension here, import file, and drag and drop the file here like this and import it. Now we need to drag and drop this file here like this, this extension. Now go to the blog section. First we need to create the Firebase account also. Let's open the new tab and just type here console.firebase.google.com. Now we need to create add project here, and our project name is music streaming app TCB, and continue. Then off this and create project. Now we need to click on continue and wait some seconds, and let's click on real-time database And then we need to click on create database. Next, enable, and make sure we have to make this true to our security, right? Wait some second, let me show you. Go to the rules here in the rules tab and make this both false to true and this one also true, like this, and make it public. Now we need to go to the data and we need to copy this URL, okay, and go to the App Inventor, go to the design, and we need to click on Firebase. So experimental drag and drop Firebase here like this and change that default URL here like this. Now we have connected the Firebase and MIT App Inventor. Now we have to connect Google Drive also. So for that we need to upload some songs in our Google Drive. So here you can see that I already have uploaded some songs in my Google Drive. So you have to upload some songs in Google Drive. Go here, you can see that one song, click on this, you can see the share option, and make sure this should be changed to any with this link, okay, and then copy link. Now this is copy. Now we need to add this URL in the Firebase, it means here. Now we have to add our URL here. Now what I will do here, I will do one simple trick here, okay. So go to the block, go to the design, you can see that previous button. So on button click, on button one click, I will store one Firebase data, dummy data, okay, simply to create my app in that database. So store value, and we will use your tag, it means text, like this, blank. This is like one, and in the second we will use your data like this, okay. And we need to run this app in AI Companion, and my app is running. So you have to run this app and we need to click on that previous button to store this data in your Firebase here, okay. Now my data is saved here, you can see that one and data. Now what I will do, go to the App Inventor, I will remove that thing. I'm just using this to create here my app. You can create that music streaming, actually you should know your app name as it is, okay, with the spelling, and then you have to do like that. Now we need your one value and we need to store here our URL. So you can see that one, make sure that is the format. You can see that is the format of data whenever you want to store the data. So you have to use here two things. First thing is you have to use your double quote and then backward slash and then backward slash and then double quote like this two times, right? Now this is the format to store our data, okay. Now go to the My Drive and copy this link, and then we have to save that link here. So I will remove that data and store that value, but make sure before I use this, I will copy this URL here to make sure to remember that value, okay, that value, this one. Now I will replace the data, it means sorry, this one, and paste it, and go to the Google Drive, copy link here and remove data and paste it and enter, save, right? Now we have to do again, for click on plus sign, name 2, and the value what we need to do, you can see in the top, you can see we need to use here. So what we need to do here, double quote, then backward slash, then double quote, then we have to put some value, okay, and then we have to use your backward slash and then double quote, that is the format. Then we have to store some value here, it means the URL. So go to the copy this, go to the MIT, go to the drive, and we need to select another music here like this one. Oh sorry, we need to just click on that and click on that share option. We need to make this change to anyone, copy link, go to the here, and we need to paste our URL between this thing here like this. Now you have to do again and again. You can add multiple songs here, you can streaming all around 100 and 200 and 500, no matter, you can stream any number of songs here. Go to App Inventor, let's go. Now here, whenever So now we have to code. One more thing we have to add here. We need your player. Okay, go to the media and you'll find here this one player, drag and drop this here. Now go to the block. Now let's do the code part. So we will create one simple list here, initial global, and that's the song list like this. And we will assign this as a empty list, like create empty list like this. Okay, whenever our screen will in a slice, it means this one, whenever a screen will in a slice, then we will get all tags of our Firebase. So suppose we have added around 4 to 5 songs links in the Firebase, then we will get all the list. So we can see the get tag list, we will call this. Now whenever we call this get tag list, so we need to call this tag list. So we will get all list here, list and value both. Now we will assign that song list to allow value, this one. Now we have all songs in this global variable, global list, song list. Now whenever we click on the next button, it means this one, next button, so we have to increase their value 1, and we have to get that one value song. It means you can see the Firebase, this one, this is the tag, and we will get that value. Okay, and we will play that value because we are fetching the song here. So go to the app inventor, then go to the block, and whenever we call this get list, whenever we click on that next button, then we have to increase the value 0 to 1. So for that we need one more variable. Okay, so we will assign this variable, and the variable name is, suppose you can see the value, and we will assign this value as a 0. Go to the designer and check next button name is button 3. So go to the block, button 3, then whenever someone click on that button 3, then we will call set global value should be increased by 1 like this, and get the current value, and that the max value is 1, increase by 1, simple. And we will display, we will set that label set text value, and the value should be this one value. In the initial stage, this value is 0. Whenever we click on the next, this will assign as a 1. Then we will get the one value in label 1.text. Now we need to get the value of our tag also. So it means whenever we click on this, so this value will be 1. So we have to get the one value, one tag's value. Okay, so this one, if that the 1 and that the value. So we need to call here the Firebase. So go to the Firebase and you will find here get value, this one. We will call between this here, this one, and then which tag we have to call? We have to call here get value tag. Okay, this value, get value, and whenever we call the value, some value, then we have to call this Firebase got value, this one. So whenever we got the value, then we will set this player, set player dot source, this one, set player 1.source, and the source should be the value, this one, right? Now for that, what we need to do, one thing here, we need to call here this extension to convert, to display that file, to convert that URL to as a song. Okay, we will call this extensions block. Okay, drive show file. Now and we will start the song. So click on the player and you will find your start song, this one, simple. Now whenever someone click on the button 2, okay, it means the stop button, then we will call simple player stop, this one. And whenever someone call the previous button, it means the previous button, then we need to call these values, similar these values. So we will copy paste this, change that button 1, and what we need to decrease the value here. So we will use our max function minus this one, we will call it here, and we will have to decrease the value from get value, and the value should be minus 1, and this should be same, but we need to use our one condition, logic, code control, if, and the logic is simple, this one, and the value, if the value, it means global variable value, it means this one, if the global variable value is not is not equal to 1, then we will minus our value. Otherwise, if the value is 1 and then we will minus the value, so this will go to 0 and maybe this will go to minus 1. So we can't play our song. So that's why we will make it till 1. So this is code for previous song. This is for the forward song, it means next song. This code for getting the value. Okay, that's the overall simple code to create your own music streaming app using MIT App Inventor. So now, using this concept, what you can do? You can create your wallpaper app also. You just need to replace the URL of that image that you have to just change it, but you have to use your one image and the source file should be same like that, what we have done here. Okay, so you can do lot more thing using this basic concept. If you have some doubt, you can ask me on comment. And thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.